right here ringside. Let me introduce Bob Geigel right here, president of NWA. Bob, delighted to have you on Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling.
It's really a pleasure to be here tonight.
And you're here for two reasons. One of them, of course, Ric Flair, who was injured last week. Bob Orton Jr., Dick Slater right here, Bob.
Yes, I sure am. They were both suspended. However, their lawyers got an injunction. We were served with an injunction. We cannot stop them from wrestling at this time. However, I have taken it upon myself and the board to fine each of these people $5,000. And before they may wrestle, $5,000 must be paid to me.
First of all, it doesn't matter. We brought the $5,000. The National Wrestling Alliance wants to fine us. That's fine. Harley Race has made sure that the $5,000 will be paid to you. Right there is $5,000 in cold cash money.
Show them the money, Dick.
Now, we knew we were going to be fined. The $5,000 we knew we were going to have to pay. There's $5,000 right here, and that's our debt. For else, what do we do from here on out? You can contact our lawyer as far as I'm concerned.
And I'll tell you that.
Jim Crockett.
In my opinion, you got off light $5,000 fine, and I'm going to get with my lawyer, and I'm going to see if the suspension can't be put back in.
$25,000 was ours. $5,000 went back to you. We'll take the $20,000. We'll enjoy ourselves. And as far as I'm concerned, Harley Race got his when he's coming from, and so did Ric Flair.
This presents a real paradox. You understand, you illiterates here? A paradox is not a couple of brain surgeons or where you park two boats. No, look it up in the dictionary. What this makes you, Crockett, as far as I'm concerned, is a 20% partner. Can you carry the weight on your shoulders? I can carry it on mine. What I did was an act of pure genius. I'm a genius. You understand that? You
we'll,
stick
at we'll, your pipe. We'll just see how smart you are.
All right, and of course, one of the other reasons you were here, and this man right here, Gary Hart, last week told the wrestling world that you were going to be here to rule in his favor this week.
Now, wait a minute. Don't you prejudice the president of the National Wrestling Alliance. I have suggested that Mr. Geigel, one of the finest presidents the Alliance has ever had, come here and give a logical and reasonable explanation to this boogie-woogie boy, this Charles Brown. Mr. Geigel, he can make his own comment. I don't have to prejudice him. Let him tell you what he said.
All right, Mr. Geigel.
Well, I've looked into the facts of this. I've looked at tapes. I didn't get to see the tape I wanted to see. However, I am going to make a decision, and the decision is going to be a just one. Now, Charlie Brown has been accused of being Jimmy Valiant. I don't know whether Charlie Brown is Jimmy Valiant or whether he is not Jimmy Valiant.
Come on. Now, how are you going to stand here and tell these people that that man is none other than Boogie Woogie Boy? You're here to give a reasonable and fair decision, and I think you ought to do that. You being the president of the National Wrestling Alliance, you have certain responsibilities not to allow ripoffs like this to take place with Charlie Brown. Now, you're a reasonable man. Show me some reason why he shouldn't be suspended forever.
Well, right here is a program from Memphis, Tennessee, where Jimmy Valiant was wrestling Memphis, Tennessee. That's one reason.
That's right. All right. There's one.
That's one. Now, I'd like to say this at this time. May I have that, please? I'd like to say at this time that the burden of proof rests with you, Gary Hart.
Why with me? Why does the burden of proof rest with me? You're the president of the National Wrestling Alliance, man. Why don't you do something about it? Why does the burden of proof have to be with me?
The National Wrestling Alliance has never made a practice of removing wrestlers' masks, and they're not going to start now. If you can prove to me, if you can remove this man's mask, then I will not only back up the fine, the suspension. If you can prove to me that Charlie Brown is Jimmy Valiant, then I will not only suspend him for the 90 days in Mid-Atlantic and worldwide, I will suspend him for 1 year in the National Wrestling Alliance.
Until November the 26th. You just made it legal for him to run around here until the 26th of November. You haven't done anything for me, Geigel. What did you do for me here today? Rip me off like them other...
He was here to make a fair and impartial decision.
You call that fair? Everybody in the world knows that Jimmy Valiant. But I'm the only one that's wise enough to see it. haven't done anything for me here today, man. What did you come here for in the first place if you weren't going to give me what I wanted?
I came to deliver what I feel and the National Wrestling Alliance feels is a fair decision.
Fair and impartial decision, fans. That decision from Bob Geigel, the president.